Thousands of boaters fueled by alcohol. The Sandbar Extravaganza is a huge party held every Labor Day weekend on Picnic Island near the Sandbar Causeway.
But last year, you can see the party got out of control. So big and so rowdy, law enforcement stepped in. This year, they're demanding changes. NBC2's George Solis tracked down the organizers and the Coast Guard to see what's ahead. George.
Well, Kelly, event organizers tell me there's no chance that this party is going to be canceled this year, but that doesn't mean it didn't come without a few changes just to make sure everyone stays safe.
Video that's almost too hot for TV, posted online by those who attended last year's Sandbar Extravaganza on Picnic Island in Lee County, a party centered around a large barge complete with a DJ and sound system.
I think it was just a bunch of people having a lot of fun.
About 3,500 people, to be exact. An event paid for through a number of community sponsors, some that almost didn't return for this year's bash.
Had some issues with law enforcement presence.
Specifically, the U.S. Coast Guard office out of Tampa. The concern over permitting. Event organizer Dan Sinclair citing one specific person for the controversy.
They're no longer with that agency, and I think they stirred the pot.
In a statement, the Coast Guard claims it reached out to the group and got nowhere. It goes on to say crews will be partnering with local law enforcement as they would any large event.
This is just a bunch of nonsense. I mean, we have a good relationship with all the local agencies.
Event promoters still erring on the side of caution.
We did try to curb some of the public opinion, and we have changed the format a little bit.
For starters, scaling the party down.
One big change this year from organizers as a way to ensure public safety is that nobody will be allowed on the barge.
Safety is always the number one concern.
Sponsors like Kenzie Eagles asking the public to just be responsible.
Bring lots of trash bags, clean up after yourself, and clean up after others that are not going to clean up after themselves.
Now, at last check on Facebook, more than 14,000 people are expected to attend this year's event. Now, the Coast Guard did tell me as far as that permitting process goes, wasn't really meant to approve or deny the big party, but rather just and I give them an idea of what to do in case of any trouble out on the water. Reporting live in St. James City, George Solis, NBC2.